In this video, what we are trying to find is the acceleration at two different points within this system here. So we are looking for both the local and the convective acceleration. So here we're given two velocity profiles. The first one here is at point one, and the second one here is at point two. In order to find the acceleration, we're going to use what's known as the material or the substantial derivative. And so what we have here is the material derivative, which consists of this local part, which is dependent on time, as well as this convective part, which is dependent on position. And we can write this in a shortcut fashion like this. So in order to find our acceleration, we have to put in these parentheses our velocity, because acceleration is the change in velocity with respect to time. Let's take a look here. We're going to find dv dt plus u dv dx plus v dv dy plus w dv dz. We're going to take our velocity profiles, each one of them, and find the acceleration at those two different points. Let's start with our first velocity, and we'll give it to you again here. So let's take the first term, which is our u with respect to t, and that's 3 times x plus y over 2 plus z over 2. Now we add to this u, which is 3t x plus y over 2 plus z over 2, times the derivative of u with respect to x, which is just 3t. We can simplify our a1, so it equals 3 times x plus y over 2 plus z over 2 times 1 plus 3t squared. So let's do the same thing for our second velocity. Find the acceleration at point 2. So our velocity is given as 6t times x plus y over 2 plus z over 2. And again, we need to find the derivative of u2 with respect to t plus u times du dx. So what happened to the other terms, the v du dy, the z du dz? Because we have only a u, we have no v or w component of velocity, those terms drop out. So when we calculate this, we end up with our a2 equals 6 times x plus y over 2 plus z over 2 plus 6t times x plus y over 2 plus z over 2. And when we simplify that, we come out with 6 times x plus y over 2 plus z over 2, all times 1 plus 6t squared. Finally, if we want to separate this acceleration between the local and the convective acceleration, remember, this is the local acceleration. It's our du dt. And this is our convective acceleration, du dx.